did Wilfried lose to these fools? I bet they couldn't even put a dent in my robot masters using those as child playthings.
Even if we don't think they'll get that far into Lacking Earth, we shouldn't take those controller pieces lightly, for they power his weapon significantly.
That Wilfried seems like weak mild sauce to me. We'll just see what happens when those two percent are put against the true Thunderbuzz material! I'll burn him! I'll destroy him! I'll whip the floor with him!
Patience, Bowser. You'll get your moment to shine in the spotlight soon enough.
If it's not over there, couldn't we just launch an ambush on them while they're asleep? I think that would be the optimal solution here.
He's got a point. I could just track down their coordinates, then we can work together to eliminate them. That way they will no longer be a threat to us anymore.
It's time to release the Glooper Blooper!
Not yet. That would be the smart option, and they'd be expecting something innovative and fresh. I have something better in mind.
Oh yeah? How is Eggman's progress with constructing the base coming along, Sir Stitch?
I don't understand the decision of putting him in charge of it. I was the scientist way before he had any games.
You were a close second pick, Dr. Wily. You're just as capable. But have you not seen his mustache? That thing looks like it could cut through bread! Before I digress, the base is coming along very nicely. We'll definitely have it finished for when the time comes.
Yes! I finally completed it! Once that Wi-Fi console is powered on, this base will send radio waves to the entire galaxy, brainwashing anyone en route. Not only that, but my greatest weapon of destruction is back in action after all these years. It's good to see you again, my beautiful masterpiece.
Alright, good to hear. But one question, who will be our next controller piece?
According to my calculations, they'll soon be approaching a little isle inhabited by what seems to be penguins and fluffy cushion-like creatures. Our ally is a dangerous polar bear from the North Pole that ended up getting stranded there. His crimes include stealing coins from the gift shop, disturbing the town with tremors, taking over the land for a month, and nearly sinking the entire island. It was an accident, but nearly sank it nonetheless. He even comes accompanied by a crab who helps him out in performing these bad deeds. This guy knows the island just as well as I know the back of my own hand. Wait, I don't remember this mole. We'll be counting on you. Herbert Percival Bear, Esquire.
Thanks for giving us tomorrow's weather report, Janice142. It's good to hear we'll have sunny skies all day, but it won't be too hot, of course. Now for our final stories of the day. It's unfortunately been reported that Madame Goombette has been found dead in her bedroom cupboard. We cannot yet confirm whether this was a murder or suicide, and investigations didn't find any traces of drug use. She was known to live a very healthy lifestyle. Coincidentally, Joseph, whom Goombette was beginning to develop feelings for, strangely disappeared just last week. Our top EPF agents are currently working their hardest to look into the links between these two cases and find a hypothesis of how she died and why. With that said, our deepest condolences here at Penguin News go out to all of Goombette's family, friends and loved ones that mourn the loss of someone that was kind and had a heart of gold.
Gosh, that poor Goombette. She was so young.
In other news, the famous hero we all know and love has mysteriously vanished without a trace. One witness, being his younger brother, last saw him leaving the house to go and visit the castle. It is believed the strange portals that have been appearing all over the island may have something to do with this mystery. With him out of the picture, it is unclear who will rescue the princess now. If you happen to find a red man in blue overalls, please let us know. And that concludes our broadcast day. Make sure you enjoy the lovely day tomorrow. And most importantly, have a good night. You deserve it, workaholics.
Is he alright? It doesn't sound like him to just run off and disappear like that.
I'm sure he's fine. Knowing him, he probably got fed up with saving the kingdom and wanted a holiday to himself without anyone knowing.
Yeah, you're right. Maybe I'm just looking too deep into this. Anyways, everything's been tidied and cleaned. Mind if I'd be able to finish?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Thanks for your help today, Brightlight 101.
My pleasure. Glad I could help.
You hurry along now. You don't want to encounter it in a dark alleyway now, do you?
What? If this is a joke, then it isn't funny.
Oh no, has no one yet told you the story of the giant radioactive Java bag?
Okay, now you're starting to scare me, Cookies and Milk.
Have you not heard? There was once a penguin who got a Java bag caught on himself, which caused him to end up falling into a pit of radioactive waste. Every 100 years on the same day of the incident, a mutated-looking Java bag can be spotted roaming the island on late rainy nights, just like this one. Or, delivery vans can end up delivering a particularly large Java bag to cafes. It's unknown how it finds its way into the imports, but it just happens. Oh, God bless those poor souls that happen to be given that bag. The Java bag lurks around, hunting for coffee shop employees like you and I to call his next victims.
Well, I best be getting home now. You know how much my Bluey loves his snacks before bedtime. Darn! I didn't bring enough coins for a ride home.
Don't worry about it. I'll give you a lift. It saves you having to spend a fortune on just one cab.
That would be great. Thank you. Let's just hope we don't run into the giant radioactive Java bag on the way.
Bright, I was only joking. I tell that story to all the workers here. I made it all up. There's no such thing as a... giant radioactive Java bag! Run for it!
I made it inside. That was easier than I expected. There it is. Unprotected and all mine for the taking! Come to Daddy, precious. These elite penguin failures won't be able to stop me now. Wow, the ocean really is beautiful. Hey, that looks like Club Penguin Island, just beyond the horizon. We should be disembarking by morning. It truly feels like an adventure now, huh?
Hi, Ivan, you okay?
Ah! Oh, it's just you. Made me jump. Sorry if I woke you.
Oh no, you didn't wake me up. I was having trouble getting sleep, but it's alright. Aren't you going to ask how I know your name?
No!
Oh, you're supposed to say yes, and then I would have had a big reveal. Oh, just forget it. The moment's ruined now. I'll just tell you. It's me. Do I not look familiar?
Mari? Is that you?
Of course it's me. Whilst you weren't looking, I snuck onto the migrator. The village has nothing to worry about, as my best friend, aka my lookalike, said she'd cover for me in being mayor until my return. She even has the voice impression now down. It's that you can't tell the difference kind of good. I want to aid you all in your quest. I just couldn't stand around and do nothing, knowing there's people out there who are far worse than Wilfrey, causing people to suffer. I sat and let the hero do everything to save our village, but no more. I want to fight for my beliefs, my friends, my father, and my future.
Thank you. It means a lot to hear you say that. There's always room for another in our team. The more the merrier, right? We'll be counting on you, Mari.
Mari has been granted permission to come aboard, join your crew, and sail the seas to help the good people in need.
There's another reason why I must come with you guys. I
see you guys are still up. and to admire the view as well.
Isaac, please don't tell anyone back at the village about this. I want to help Ivan and his friends in doing whatever it takes to stop Sarasich.
I understand. You never go back on a decision, so I won't try to stop you. Your secret is safe for me, Mary. I support your decision, and I will intend to help you however I can, Mayor.
Thank you, Isaac. You won't regret it.
I had a feeling we'd find you all here.
Chris, Doug, Gyro, I've come to help everyone out.
Mari, it's good to see that you've changed your mind to accompany us.
Yes, okay.
No, of course not. We were just talking. That's all we were doing, really.
Don't blame you. Seems like a decent place to just vibe and chat.
Anyways, I need to tell you all something. It's about...
Shiver me timbers, we be fast approaching a large red belly piranha.
Ugh, it's way too early for this shit.
Oh dear. We know the drill. Is everyone ready?
We can do this, guys.
I want the last line. Let's see what we're dealing with.
Wait! Stop! That's not a red-bellied piranha! It's the captain! Rockhopper, wow! It really is you!
Ye bet your extra anchovy pizza it'd be me, lads!
We're all glad we managed to find you in one piece, Rockhopper. You're right here, and we're also relieved to see you're okay.
My bad, Captain. I mistook you for one of them no-good piranhas.
Apology be accepted, Barrowman Big Yoshi. Now who's got me cream soda and a bottle of water? We be thirsty out here after that salvage attempt. Ain't that right, Yar?
Pleased to make your acquaintance, Rockhopper. I am Chris Hansen from Dateline NBC, and I'm sure we'll get along just fine as long as there's no miners in your quarters.
So cool! A captain on the ship that actually has a bed!
At least our English isn't broken, and we actually use our legs to walk.
I'll be taking back to that hill. Thank you, lad. Next up, Cobb Penguin Island.
Oh ho!
Ahoy, Club Penguin! We be back from our exciting voyage! Now to get a trim on me beard! No, wait! Me beard be perfect!
Yeah, it's a bit nervy, but it's nothing I propose again, handle. Now, where would be a suitable place to set up shop?
You can all treat yourselves to some sightseeing if you want. Just come on down to Gary's Potions and Gadgets once you're ready to come collect your goodies. It's the rightmost building in the ski village. You can't miss it.
Alright, we'll do, Gary. Kim, you good?
Must resist urge to squeal like a fanboy. That's pretty cool, we're in Club Penguin. The ski village is just up north from here, isn't it?
Ye be correct.
I wonder if there's somewhere I can get my Rappo coins exchanged.
What are we waiting for? Disney's Robin Hood too? Let's do some shopping in Club Penguin already, dammit! Yo, they have a Sainsbury's here as well?
When was this a thing?
The cookies made them so successful that they started branching out their brand to other dimensions.
Really? Oh, good for them.
It's always worth having a look to see what delights they have on offer. They even have an Argos in store, so they must be pulling out all the fancy levers for this one.
Let's use our money wisely.
You
like, I'm being attacked, man. Someone help.
It's coming from over there.
Scooby-Doo, where are you?
It's Shaggy. He's in trouble. Oh, Ken, I forgot to mention. You can attack an enemy from behind to give us the first attack in a battle. However, it can also work against us if an enemy manages to surprise you. If that happens, they'll be able to move first and have us surrounded, putting us in a bad position and making it harder to leg it. So try not to let that happen. Ambushing an enemy will always give us an advantage and be the difference between a victory and a defeat.
Alright. We got first strike. Let's see come. I got the zoomies.
Burn to a crisp!
You call me Brian,
jolly
bitch!
Good gyro. You hit its weakness.
Beginning scan. These enemies are capable of freezing a solid and dealing immense damage to any of them that becomes an ice ball. Don't get reckless, guys.
Let's give this a try.
Ouch. That really hurt.
We must protect our injured friends. I'm ready when you are, Ken.
Alright, Gyro's all fired up. Everyone's gonna love this one.
You ready?
You bet. Let's do this.
That ain't Falco. That ain't Falco. Oh! 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 Where are you at? Where are you at? Where are you at?
Yeah! Oh! He's on company. Oh,
get your ass whooped.
What? Wait! Hold up. Please, Barry! I'm too young to die! I'm sorry for all the trouble I've caused you guys! I promise I'll do anything! I'll make it up to you! Anything!
Join my cause, Arsewipe. What? I didn't say that. Sorry. That came out way more aggressive than I intended.
Wow! That was harsh! Despite it looking like a perfectly nice dialogue option! That's okay. That sounded like a genuine hee-ho! Apology. Hold on! It's all coming back to me! I am Val. Thou art I. I am Jack Frost, a demon that lives in the sea of the human heart. That asshole Sarosich brainwashed me. He thinks I'm his slave. Well, I'm not! Ho! Oh, I'll be the best demon you've ever partnered with. Let's work together and cook Sarosich up the cold dish of sweet revenge. Take good care of me while you're in. Hee-ho!
Fucking noobs.
Finally.
Like, thanks, guys. You saved my tender behind. You were so cool, man. No problem. We're always here to help anyone in trouble. Now, fighting those no-good punks has made me hungry. As a thanks for rescuing me, I'll cook you whatever ingredients you bring me from now on. Like, have you found any food? When you do, just look for me in my trusted porta kitchen, and I'll cook us one of my delicious meals. Well, if you change your mind, I'll be here to whip us up a good Scooby snack, man. That reminds me, where did Scoob get off to? Why can't come running for my girl by now?
Spence, he dies. Over here.
Hey, it's Matt from Wii Sports.
Wow, it is. He was so hard to beat in Wii Boxing.
That's because it was you playing the game, sweetheart.
You guys should come in and try the new charms I've just forged, or maybe practice your fighting skills against my combat bunnies. If you don't trust my products, I'll give you a free sample of four of my most popular charms. Here you go. understand if you guys are busy right now, but be sure to check out my store tent whenever you get the chance. I'm constantly releasing new charms. One story stuff hack, but I mean, when new materials are delivered here.
Ah, Ages from Another World, you chose the perfect time to join us. The whole team is here, Jetpack Guy, Rookie, Dot, and Daniel. Introduce yourselves, you guys.
Hello, I'm Jetpack Guy. I'm the Eye of the Sky. I wear sunglasses to let you know how cool I am. This fuel-filled backpack allows me to fly faster than a snail tied to a rocket. You'll mostly see me using my jetpack to accomplish missions, because personally, I prefer the air.
I don't think that quote belongs to you, Jetpack Guy.
Does it not? Crud. Guess I gotta find something else.
Do you howdy? My name's Rookie, and people give me that name because I'm rather accident-prone and I'm still in a turnaround here. That's not actually my name. My real one's too silly to say. You may have seen me wearing a propeller cap earlier, but now I'm wearing a shirt. Oh, wait, maybe that wasn't you guys.
Hello, my name is Dot. Dot the Disguise Gal.
Hey guys, it's me!
My speciality is being the Master of Disguise. Pleased to meet you all.
I'm Daniel, and my code name is Frostbite. But you can call me whichever. Actually, I wanted to ask for assistance from your group, but I see you already have a full plate. Please help me out later if you get the chance.
Ah, it looks like the kettle's boiled too. Double perfect. As much as I love a good cup of tea, we'd rather not waste any more time. Could we just have the controller piece, please, Gary? Oh goodness, I'm ever so sorry. You should have just said to help remind me. Here, let me find it for you guys.
What's up, Gary?
It's gone.
You lost it? You absolute dipshit!
I swear, I put it right here in this cabinet.
You don't seem like the type of person to tell lies, so we believe you, Gary.
Yeah, I'm with Chris. Surely there must be an explanation for this.
Agents, common agents, I'm here to report while you may be lacking some tools in this command room.
Hey, I know you.
You do? Well, you never know. You may have met me before and found out about my true identity. Welcome, new recruits. I am the director, leader of the EPF.
If you guys didn't already know, we're a part of an organization known as the Elite Penguin Force, EPF for short. We strive to protect the penguins in the island from any critical threats.
Albert is back to perform his usual bad deeds, and this time, he's attempting to repair his giant drill in order to dig underneath the island again.
You mean that same giant drill which caused that massive earthquake back then?
Precisely. I've done some research, and it looks like he's made a few modifications to the model, with one of them, most notably, being its unique ability to enter gold items as a source of fuel. What I'm trying to say is Herbert's been stealing gold artifacts from around the island, with the latest report from the owner of the coffee shop being the missing rare mug on display.
No wonder I can't find my gold knight's armor in my wardrobe. That bear has gone too far.
I am assigning you all a new mission to capture him and his sidekick, Clutzy, once and for all. Jetpack Guy, I want you to fly into the wilderness to place down these cameras to help Gary track Herbert's location and find out what his true intentions are.
Understood.
Dot, find your best Golden Puffle outfit and use it to lure Herbert to the dance club, where you'll find the real thing lying on a pedestal. Upon removing the Golden Puffle, that point of bat will have an enormous cage for on it.
AA!
Okay, you'll go to the nightclub and set up the cage trap. Then, I want you to help out at the clothes shop, as that freakishly large magnet needs repairing.
Okie dokie!
At first, you'll be on run and gunner. I'm trusting you in keeping everyone on the island safe. If Herbert shows any signs of violence and aggression, give him a good charge shot.
Sounds good to me.
You agents will go out and check on the others to see if they need any help with their tasks for the mission. I'm sending you a brand new spy phone now, which will have everyone's contacts saved onto it.
Guys, we got an actual EPF spy phone! This is sick!
It even has a built-in map with a tracking device that can display where the others are located at this exact moment. Give it a try!
Thank you, Director. We won't let you down.
I'm certain that if we all work together, make a move, and then plan the scheme. Good luck, agents. Director out.
I'll continue looking into what Herbert is currently up to once Jetpack Guy sets up all the cameras. Now, I've built a special sled that can support up to 5 people around back in my shop once you're ready to go check on him. But for now, I'd suggest checking up on Rocky in the clothes shop first. That trap shouldn't have taken too long for him to set up.
No problem, Gary. Let us crack on with it, guys.
Hey, let's try teleporting there with the spy phone.
Oh, I remember this. But I forgot how it works.
Could it be this button?
I see you guys have come to assist your friend, but could you just sort something out before you go over? Sorry to be a pain.
Certainly. What seems to be troubling you?
That guy over there is trying on so many clothes. He looks like he has no intentions of paying for any of it. I can see him stuffing a lot in a sack. Yeah, I see you over there! I asked him earlier why he has so many clothes. He said, oh, it's to make me look fabulous. Can you just tell him not to do that? He looks like he's better than a thief.
Well, he sounds like a fun handful.
These glasses would be so cute on someone like me. I can't wait to listen to some music on my way home. I'd best be cautious. I don't want that shopkeeper stealing my fruity ass stealing.
I'm afraid we'll have to stop you right there. What are you doing?
What's it to you, melee boy? I've got to take a bath. I must be perfect, and these would go nicely with my outfit. Honestly, you should be taking notes, nerd.
Stealing's not the Jedi way. Unless you're going to pay for those. Please remove the contents from the bag, and we'll all be cool.
What Chris said. Come on, man. Just give the clothes back to the shop.
This bad bitch has a name, and you should get to learning. Mr. Fabius don't go down easy, and you'll learn such day. Fine. I'll return the clothes.
You will? Wow. That was easier than I thought it would be.
If you fight me for them. Here I come, Dorothy.
Wait, what?
You just had to open trap, didn't you?
Unlike me, it's time you pay what you owe. Tom Nook says your rent's due.
No way you can hit me.
Oh, fuck!
Nice one, Doc. You found his weakness. People will use King DDD bathwater.
Wow. You're using a lame strat that was that? I'm not surprised someone with a style as lazy as that's using a strategy just as lousy.
Hey Chris, I have a question.
Ask away.
Why is it in some battles you have your regular attire and in others wear a gingerbread head?
If you didn't know already, you can change the costumes we wear in battle. It doesn't affect how we fight, but it's fun to play around with our different cosmetic styles. At the moment my outfit's set to randomize between the two, but from now on I'll let you choose how you want to customize my look.
I like the gingerbread head. It makes you look like a hunter. I'd say keep it.
King DDD's bathwater.
Oh my god. You have King DDD bathwater too? I remember you. Oh, you're Kenzoku. You're the one who managed to get Nintendo to greenlight King DDD's bathwater. I guess you aren't as foolish as you look.
Yep, that's me. Look out, Mr. Fabulous! Jeffrey Leonard, the Australian paedophile, is right behind you!
Yeah, boys.
Help! Get this disgusting guy pants off me! For once, I'm not enjoying this.
Fear not, Fabulous. I know exactly how to deal with molesters.
Sex with anybody.
Hello, my name's Nino.
No.
April
Fool. You are a shithouse.
Power of Christ compels you, bitch.
You're enjoying this, aren't you?
No, we're not Jeffrey Leonard. You tried touching our friend Mr. Fabulous, and now you're gonna get what's coming to you.
Please take a seat.
No!
Not in the scratch. Nice, another level.
Mr. Fabulous, are you okay?
Thanks, guys. There might be some queen-like potential left. That was a great justice being served with a bread roll. Alright, I'll put the clothes back. From now on, this guy is an honest princess that will pay for clothes with his own money.
We're glad to hear we turned your life around for the better, Mr. Fabulous.
Anyways, I must be going now. I might just have to keep my eyes on you, and if you know me, there's nothing I'm better at.
See you, Fabulous!
That looked pretty wild over there, but you managed to deal with all that, no sweat. Here's a little something for your troubles. Thanks again.
Thanks. Hell yeah! I can do some serious damage with this!
Your buddy's just over there. He looks like he may need some help with the magnet.
Oh no. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Please work, giant magnet. Pretty please.
Rookie, report in.
Sir, yes sir. Set up the magnet 3000 as instructed. Magnet doesn't seem to be working. Awaiting further orders, sir, is what I would be saying. But I managed to set up the magnet all by myself, whilst you were over there preventing a shoplifting. I guess you could say this was my character development arc established.
You mean, we teleported all the way here for nothing?
Not necessarily. We did help the shopkeeper out and earned you a new weapon.
True. I guess I shouldn't be too tilted.
Nonetheless, I still really appreciate the help. I'll give you guys this if it makes it more worthwhile.
I suggest we head to the pet shop next to check on Doss progress.
Good idea, Chris.
Well, the magnet's still up and running. If Herbert grabs a hold of the golden puffle, he'll be no match for this magnificent magnet.
Stay on alert, and let us know if you see or hear anything, rookie.
Aye aye, Commander.
These puffle creatures are so adorable. Can we adopt one? Please? Pretty please?
Well, we've arrived at the pet shop, but where could Dot be?
Howdy, fellas.
Well, that's something you don't see every day.
My current report is I was unable to obtain a golden puffle outfit, as the pet shop staff are still yet to give it a 5-minute wash.
Where the pet house, though?
I decided to settle on the house, just to help me blend in with the surroundings in here. Besides, it really feels like home.
That joke was truly cringe-worthy, Dot.
Anyways, Gary wanted me to give you peeps this note that contains a special code. Try and see if you can decipher it.
I've never seen anything like this before. How about you guys?
I remember these tit-tat-toe codes in Club Penguin, but I forgot how to solve them.
I always had trouble decoding these suckers, until one of my other good friends showed me and explained what each symbol translated to. Just give me a moment to jog my memory. The first symbol is an E, and the second is an L. Decoding the rest of the characters, and the final word we're left with is 11.
11? 11 what? This makes no sense to me!
Good work, Otherworld agents. That's two of the three teammates who need to be checked on. Now you just need to head out to the wilderness to find and help Jetpack Guy, and we'll be all set.
We'll need that sled you mentioned earlier, Gary, to help us get down there safely. Pleased we'd be able to borrow it.
Of course. Return to me in my store, and I'll provide you with the 5-person sled. Aiden GL.
Don't worry about me, Ace. I'll definitely have the costume the next time you lot see me.
Nice to see you're all getting the hang of Spyfon travel. Now, before I entrust you with the sled, there's one question I must ask that will prove to me that you really are part of the EPF. How many lab coats do I own?
What? How am I supposed to know the answer to that? Spare us the bullshit and give us a sled already! We don't have time for your games, Gary!
Crud, another unexpected brick wall blocks our path.
Oh, you're right! The code that was on the note! I got it. You own 11 lab coats, Gary.
Correct. So you are true EPF agents. I'm impressed. As promised, here's the 5-person sled.
The mission has nearly been completed. I used to have this feeling in my gut that made me think you will succeed, but now, I know you guys can't fail this mission. Good luck out there, agents. That's odd.
What's the matter, Ken?
The phone's no longer picking up Jetpack Guy's signal. Could he have gotten lost?
It doesn't sound likely. I've read his wiki bio, and it says that he's had experience with that area before. Perhaps he must have flown out of Reading's range, but that would mean that he is no longer on Club Penguin, and the director didn't assign us to do any outbound travel. None of this adds up.
That wouldn't be good. I do hope he's okay.
Okay or not, standing around crying about it won't benefit us in the slightest. We were given this for a reason. So let's get our asses on it and ride down there! It's time to get some use out of this bad boy.
This is amazing!
This beats any of the setting I've done back at the village.
Everyone, look out for that tree!
The sled isn't going at the correct velocity. We're not going to make it.
Yes, we are. I got an idea. Everyone tilt towards that ice patch. It'll give us the boost we need to cross the gorge.
Are you crazy? It's not going to work. Let's all just turn one direction to attempt to slow this thing down.
We're going too fast for the sled to slow down. We'll just fall right off the cliff. Trust me, I know what I'm doing.
All right, it's all or nothing at this point.
An answer was all we needed. Come on, it's worth a shot. Lean to the right, guys.
This is so freaking cool. But I wish I had something to say in slow motion.
Talk about a rough landing.
Ken? You alright?
I hit my head on the tree stump and that really hurts.
This should help. The heel's on me.
Cheers, dude. I feel much better now.
Well, we made it to the oneness. Let's begin the search for the jetpack guy.
There he is!
Report, jetpack guy. What happened?
Herbert captured me, stole my phone, then tied me to this tree with a rocket strapped to my back. Get me off this crazy ride.
It looks as if Herbert left his fishing rod behind the tree. We can use it to reel him in.
Great idea, Maury. Now hold still, jetpack guy.
I can only try.
Cue the unfitting happy minigame music!
Stop this crazy rocket so you can untie me! Use Chirp's flute to disable the jet engine. You may need to gain her trust first, though.
Hey, Chirp. Want an Opry?
That oughta do it.
You think you can play that flute to shut down that rocket? Nice going, Chirp!
Thanks, boss. Get these ropes off me and we'll be good to go.
I got this one. Critical claw!
Awesome! Great job, guys! Now quick! Everyone in the bushes!
Ow! Easy!
And where do you think you're touching, mister?
Ouch! My hand slipped! I'm trying to get a good view! And not that kind, not that kind!
Care to explain why you pushed us into the bushes?
Yeah. What's this all about, jetpack guy?
It's Herbert and Klutzy! They're just over there! Check the binoculars! See if you can hear in on what he's saying as well.
I finally obtained the spy phone. Just like taking candy from a baby. With this phone, I'll be able to sneak this stuff to the underground, where I can insert it all into the drill. Right after I grab the golden puff, of course, I will dig under all of Club Penguin, sinking the entire town. Then, I can finally build my own ideal paradise. Those idiots won't even know what hit them. Enter password. I don't remember them having that feature. No way! There are like a million possible combinations! That would take us forever!
That monster, he is a troublemaker. That sounds unlike him to do something that awful. Alright, now we know his true intentions.
We should report to headquarters immediately and inform the director and Gary on what we've gathered.
Wait, where did they go?
Hey, where did they go?
That's what I just said.
You know, for a big guy, he was pretty quick.
Well, he is a polar bear, so I'm not surprised there.
He left my phone behind. I swear, if he's broken it, I'm not gonna be a happy bunny. Locked up for an hour? Dang, and I had Herbert destroy my jetpack by throwing a rock at it. This just hasn't been my day. How am I supposed to get back up there now?
Do not fret, jetpack guy, for we have a unit of our own. In fully working order, I might add. You leave the teleporting to us.
Guys? This probably isn't important. But I saw Herbert chasing after Dot in a golden puffle costume. It looked like they were headed for the coffee shop.
She was supposed to lead Herbert to the nightclub. He and Klutzy must have been blocking her way. This can't be good.
We'll be there as soon as possible, Rookie. Try and distract Herbert in any way you can in the meantime.
Roger, can do. I'm a very distracting penguin. Agent Rookie, out.
Stay close, jetpack guy. We about to be schmoovin'!
You guys go and help Rookie and Dot. I'll go to the command room and grab another jetpack.
Really, bitch? At a time like this? You gotta be fucking kidding me. We could do of your help right about now.
But it has plot importance, as you'll soon find out in 2 scenes' time.
Oh, for God's sakes, hurry then!
At long last, I have you now, Golden Puffle. That makes this the final piece of my island domination jigsaw puzzle.
Stop. Get away from me.
Come on, Rookie. Do something. Everyone's counting on you. You sound right here. Oh, what's the use? I can't do anything right. All I know how to do is sound right here with fools and throw a great party. Throw a great party. Wait, that's it?
I've been saving this for just the occasion.
Happy birthday, Herbert!
What's going on? It's not my birthday today. I hate crowds and loud music.
Quick, Herbert's distracted. Now's your chance to bail.
Huh? What the?
Follow the golden puffle, Herbert. You know you want to.
Hey, get back here!
That was amazing what you did back there, Rookie. Thanks a bunch.
We'll have time for praising later. We gotta hide.
I have to go. There's something I must do at the clothes shop.
No, Rookie. You'll be caught by Herbert.
He's gone, Dot. We just gotta have faith in him for now. He'll be okay.
You're right. He'll be fine. I just know it.
Newsflash, guys! We're being chased by an enormous polar bear that's not a bear tick. Does finding a hiding spot ring any tubular bells?
Alright. Sorry.
Wait, did anyone see Mari come in with us?
Where'd you go, Goldie? A trap! Wait a minute, this all looks too familiar. It's a good thing I have this convenient can of worms which weighs the exact same as the real Golden Puffle. Ha! Good try, Agent, but better luck next time. Maybe I should teach you how to set a proper trap.
Now, pull the lever, Ken!
Need I remind you that not only am I considerably more intelligent than you, but also much stronger. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must be off.
All agents, move in.
Thanks for calling us, Mari. We're here to help.
I'm back with another jetpack. What did I miss?
Rookie!
I has returned.
Oh no you don't! That golden puffle is mine!
The magnet isn't strong enough to hold him.
I've got a clear view of the suspect. What are your orders?
Hand me your jetpack. I'm gonna do what's called a pro gamer move. Nice, we got him!
See? What did I tell you earlier? You're under arrest for theft of many possessions you've stolen from us, Herbert.
Great work, everyone. You all handled the mission well.
You pesky people and penguins! Release me at once, or face my wrath!
You're not going anywhere, Herbert.
Do you have anything to say before we lock you up for a good long while?
Can I at least make one phone call to someone?
Of course, here. You can use my phone.
Rookie, no!
Nice try, agents. But I win this round.
Why is it always two steps forward, three steps back with you, Rookie?
Rookie, please report back to the command room. We need to have a short discussion on proper prisoner handling.
Okay.
Wait, Rookie? Where did you set the phone to teleport to last?
I had to go to the underground to grab one of Gary's solar panels in order to fix the magnet.
That's it! The underground! That's where Herbert said he and Clutzy been keeping the drill! We still have time to stall them if we hurry! Come on, guys, let's go!
Good luck, guys. We'll be counting on you.
Everyone hop in. We're going for a ride.
Table's in the wrong position. We'll end up riding right off that cliff if we don't do anything about that switch.
Leave it to me, Chris. Ready? Aim. Fire!
Nice going, Mori! You did it!
Yes! You go, girl!
Loop to loop incoming! No! I think we've been on enough rides at this wacky amusement park.
Hey, it's that Mel Orb pedestal you guys explained to me off screen. We should definitely use it.
If there's a Mel Orb pedestal here, then that means we'll most likely have to fight Herbert and Clutzy beyond that room. Let's make sure we're prepared and fully healed before we go kick some ass.
I'm with Gyro.
I agree as well.
Good call, Gyro. No complaints from me there. I think we're all ready and prepared to take back Club Penguin. Let us advance forward. Hello again, Epic Penguin fools. Nice of you all to pop in. You couldn't have chosen a better time. You lot will be the first to witness the new and improved Earthquake Driller in all its glory! I guess you could say this is my way of thanking you for your stupidity in handing me that spy phone. I've never rewarded anyone, let alone this well, before. You should all be honored. Behold! Oops, wrong app. Behold! The latest Earthquake Driller model, optimized to run on gold as another source of fuel! In 10 minutes, this drill will begin its course around the island, sinking every building and penguin down below. Then, I will be able to dig back up and begin my renovation plans to build an ideal paradise. I will finally put an end to Penguin Party nonsense!
This is madness. You don't understand. There won't be anything to build your so-called paradise on. Your actions will sink the entire island, killing thousands of innocent people.
Exactly what Mari said. Stop this chaotic contraption at once, Herbert.
He's not listening, Chris. Zerostitch has him more brainwashed than a cult member. We'll have to deal with him the same way we dealt with Wilfrey.
Now that platform you're currently standing on doesn't look very stable. It'd be an awful shame if anything with sharp claws came along to cut it down. You wouldn't dare. Try me. Klutzy, attack! Nice work, Klutzy! Just a few more sniffs like that, and we'll be golden! Give me a high five! Careful! You almost caught a wire there. Don't apologize! Just don't do it again, capiche?
The drill's outer shell looks resistant to physical and magic attacks. There must be some other way we can disable it before it finishes shutting off power to dig. I'll continue looking into it as the battle goes on. Klutzy and his sharp claws will also prove to be very irritating in the fight. We must do everything in our power to stop him from reaching us and attempting to cut our platform down. Guys, I've sussed out what we need to do.
Same here.
If we can somehow manipulate Klutzy to cut those wires...
We may be able to stop the machine and put an end to Herbert's evil plan.
Now that's an idea I can get behind. Let's do it!
You wish you had a trifold map right now.
Alright, Chris Hansen. You has enemy confused.
Beginning scan. These are the results I uncovered.
Let's listen to some music.
Klutzy! What on earth are you doing? Well, at least that was only the nightlight wire and not anything important.
It working. Keep it up. Scratch.
Beating it regularly will take us eons. Let's find another way to take it down.
That won't work right now. I can't reach any of my targets.
I wish I had a second audio clip for this.
Stop that! Stop that right now, Klutzy! You're unintentionally ruining my master plan!
I can't think of anything right now, just do the move.
We did it!
It's gonna blow! No! My beautiful drill! That's it! I'm going to make you all regret doing that!
We'll just see about that, you pompous polar bear.
Too slow.
Nice dodge, I mean dodge, Ivan aka Kinzoku.
Impossible! Jack Frost!
You pissed me off, you son of a bitch! Back off!
Shocking, isn't it?
Aid me, Book of Life. Yeah.
Chris Hansen doesn't look so hot. I'd suggest healing him. I wish I was you.
Beautiful chicken.
I prefer a medic, but this is pretty good.
Ring, 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 ring. Banana phone.
Die, motherfucker, die!
Cursed!
Mari, take this.
Thanks, Chris. Take these.
Thank you.
You is my new friend.
Oh, thank God for that.
Nom, nom, nom.
It was nice of you all to let me pick the new venue of choice for my birthday party. Now we can celebrate it my way. As thanks, I'll make sure you all have a ball. A snowball.
What's he plotting now?
I don't know. Stay on your guard, everyone.
Yikes! That's quite the snowball he has there.
That's quite big. Impressive.
He gun throw it at us. Me think would be in our best interest to defend. Everyone, prepare for lot of stinging.
Uh-huh. attack drained half of my HP! I'll have to deal with that once I've had a little rest. Okay, Herb is on the floor. Time to finish this, guys!
Herbie being knocked down. Hit him with strongest attacks, everyone.
Impossible! I can't be defeated! Sarosich promised me the power to help me conquer Club Penguin! No! No! I won't! I won't lose today! Not even to the likes of you guys! Or anyone else for that matter!
That's where you would be wrong, stupid.
Hey, buddy. Been looking for you. Just wanted to come say, you owe me a spy phone.
And you owe me my Gold Knight's armor.
Give it up already, Herbert. We have you surrounded. Every inch of this cave has been filled with security. So don't try any funny business with us.
You can't stop us!
Going somewhere?
Agent Frost!
End of the line, Percival Bob.
Oh, man. Oh. We did it! The island is safe once again! Astounding job, everyone! I can imagine Herbert's no longer being brainwashed by Sarosich, so he'll most likely return to his usual grouchy evil self when he regains consciousness. That's no recent news to us, though. We'll have him locked up in our super-tight security chamber, so it's safe to bet he won't be bothering us anytime soon. And if he does, we'll be ready for him. I noticed there was no sign of the drill back there. You guys must have done some work to it. Fortunately, all the golden possessions Herbert had nabbed are all intact. It truly is a miracle.
For real? Damn, Yoko must be made of some sort of tendium for it to not disintegrate.
I managed to come across this upon rummaging through the pile of the golden goods. I believe this is what I promised you all back at HQ. I truly am sorry for being foolish and leaving it behind instead of taking it with me to the Repulsa Village. Are you kidding me? An excuse to go on an adventure with my friends is the excuse of a lifetime. I'm just glad I can help and feel like I've been useful. You have all proven to be selfless and excellent EPF agents. Please accept this as a thank you from all of us for protecting Club Penguin. Here, catch. I also happened to stumble across this lying among the same pile. It must be important if Herbert had been keeping it in his grasp. I'm not sure what it does, but I'm picking up incredible off-the-chart energy readings from these goggles. I suggest you take it with you too. A Chaos Emerald? What's that doing here in Club Penguin?
I don't know, kid. Even I can't explain that phenomenon. If the Chaos Emeralds are scattered across the dimension, that would mean buddies wouldn't be too far away to snag them. We should try and collect all the emeralds we can find along the way. They may prove to be helpful later on.
Anyways, there is no reason for us to hang around here. Let's make our way back up and return to HQ.
We totally rock. I wanted to ask, have you guys made a team name yet?
You know what? That never crossed my mind. We should make one. Let's start brainstorming some ideas.
I demand we settle on something JoJo-related.
We need a name that will have the enemy shaking in their boots, saying, "Oh no, it's Team Blank. Their awesomeness is too much for us to handle." Like Team LAN Adapter, considering we're stopping people that are using lag switches.
That is brilliant. But I like the diamonds. There, I said the ha-ha funny gyro word! Oh, that 4 or so month wait was worth it!
We could try merging two words together. How about Team Never Diamond?
He's more intelligent. I believe Team Stardust Crusaders will be better suited for us all.
Ooh! I got it! Team Network Crusaders.
That's a great name, Ken.
Indeed, you have my vote.
I think that name would fit really well for you guys.
That's an awesome name. Then it's settled. Team Network Crusaders it is.
Let's continue to change the universe for the better. To Team Network Crusaders!
To Team Network Crusaders!
Give it up already, Herbert. We have you surrounded. Every inch of this cave has been filled with security, so don't try any funny business with us, you stupid baka.